Welcome to this session of 5G Overview and The Way to 6G, presented by LearnIzo Global. In this module, we are going to discuss about why 5G is important, 5G key enablers, 3GPP evolutions, LTE EPC network architecture, 5G network architecture, way forward to 6G. World will need millions of skilled people. For 5G rollouts, companies are struggling to hire people with these new age skills. There is a huge skill industry gap in telecom, even for experienced people. Telecom industry is growing at fast pace. . 5G brings a $500 billion business opportunity for companies. Let us understand what are the major enablers for 5G. Cloud native, a centralized cloud native architecture for both radio and core. Massive MIMO, a system with multiple antenna for transmission and reception. Millimeter wave, use of high frequencies in 20 to 100 GHz. Multi-access edge computing, bringing user plane closer to the end users to enhance QoE. Network function virtualization, decoupling software from the hardware and virtualize network's functions. Software defined networking, separation of control plane and user plane for efficient management. Network slicing, utilization of single physical infra to create multiple logical networks. Orchestration, end-to-end efficient management of the network. In this picture, we can see the evolutions from 1G to 5G networks. 1G networks were mainly analog networks, providing voice services, and had a very limited deployment. The real breakthrough came when we started with 2G, which is a GSM network that came with voice and SMS services, and later also supported data services using GPRS and edge technologies. 3G network provided little higher data rates compared to 2G, and also enhanced this experience with HSDPA and HSPA+. Both 2G and 3G networks had circuit switching as well as packet switching for data transfer in 4G. We started with pure packet switching networks and data rates of up to 1 Gbps. 5G promises data rates up to 20 Gbps in downlink and integrates many new verticals with telecom networks. In 4G networks, we only have packet switching, and at the same time, Node B and RNC functionality are combined in 4G. And the new node is called eNode B. SGSN functionality of 3G is divided into two parts. One is MME, which does the control plane part, which is signaling. And the other one is SGW, which does the user plane part and manage traffic. PGW comes in the place of GGSN of 2G and 3G networks. HSS replaces the HLR of 2G and 3G networks. PCRF is a node defined to manage quality of service and charging rules. In 5G networks architecture, eNode B is replaced with gNode B and does a more or less similar function to eNode B, that is, interfacing with UE at one end and core network on another side. However, the core network architecture of 5G is very different than EPC of 4G. And you can see a lot of new network functions in 5G core networks. AMF does functions similar to MME and manages the access and mobility. SMF takes care of session management. AUSF is responsible for authentication and security. UDM is managing user data and successor of HSS. PCF is taking care of QoS management. UPF is forwarding the user data between user and external data networks. However, there are some new network functions defined that are completely new to 5G. That is, NRF, NSSF, and NEF. NRF is an NF repository function that keeps the information about all available network function instances. NSSF helps the AMF to choose the right slices for the user. NEF allows external third-party applications to consume the data of 5G networks and users to provide some value-added services to 5G customers and create new revenue generation opportunities for mobile network operators. We are yet to realize the 5G networks in actual, but standardization work is going on for 6G as well. Let us understand, what are the expectations from 6G? Global coverage from satellite to terrestrial to maritime networks. Using a variety of spectrums, from sub 6 GHz to terahertz. As networks are becoming open, they should be more secure. Networks should be driven by artificial intelligence and machine learning. Please visit our website www.learnisaglobal.com for more such videos, blogs, trainings and information. Thank you.